like to present our project, successful, we are sure, successful project. But before we start, we would like to invite you to have a brief look to Midlandsia, to understand what is Midlandsia, what kind of people live in Midlandsia, and what we have. Please.
Is it a little slower?
Does your project include investments in IT infrastructure in Midlandsia?
Yes.
Midlandsia has great economic results, but the slowdown of the and the recessions in the European Union countries has slowed down our economy. Unlike its Central European neighbors, including those of Ovonia, Sturgeon Republic, Transcarpia, and Wallachia, who have deep decline in both stock exchange listings and national currency rates. Midlandsia initially was not affected by the economic crisis. This is mostly due to its convergence criteria and tying of the Midlandian taler to the euro. Due to the global recession in late 2008, that's when Midlandsia's economy started to slow down. This is mostly attributed to the decrease in demand for Midlandsia's products from its major trading partners. We have a decrease in exports by 17.5%, a production increase by 10.2% within 2008. However, the European Commission has reported that Midlandsia is the country that is best handling this economic crisis. Compared to Central Europe and the European Union members. Its project GDP for 2009 reached growth of 2.7%. Less in 2008, this was 7%, so it's considerably less, but nevertheless, it's still okay. This is mostly due to lower export dynamics. The growth increase in exports has been only 0.7% for 2009, while 2 years before that it was 23%. This has been a pretty dramatic slump. This is also mostly due to its car industry, which makes up for 30% of Finlandia and its exports. So with the car industry being hit by the economic crisis, it's really affected us. Also, another of the biggest potential problems for Finlandia is the high conversion of dollar to euro conversion rate. This has had a negative influence on its competitiveness with countries outside the European zone. Already, the producers of Geeky Gadgets, an electronic company, and GPGP car producers have decided to transfer parts of their production to Ferrovia, which is partially due to the rising wage increase. Also, the employment sector has been hit pretty hard by the economic crises. We have lost 10% of jobs in the last 6 months, and 30% of these are within the minority groups. Also, 15% of the population fear that they're going to lose their job within the next 6 months. Again, 40% of these is the minority group, so you're seeing a trend with the minorities having a bigger percentage. Ultimately, there's also, on average, 5% of the population is worried that within the next 6 months, they're not going to be able to pay for their bills. And this is 15% of this is composed to by the minorities. So there is again a big disparity between minorities and the majority of the population. And now I would like to show a video of what some people think in our country about the economic crisis.
We don't have any kind of problem. We just produce cars, whoop, jeep, and I think that it is going well, so it wasn't even though I'm doing well, pretty well with my car industry and the whoop, jeep. I have a big selling course, but I'm thinking about my employees that they are earning too much in this country. And I'm taking into consideration to go to another country and to open a car industry and just to have more profit because of that.
I'm Olaf Grant. What do you think about implementing green projects in Finlandia?
Oh, green projects? Yeah, I think I've heard something about it. I mean, it comes up into these newspapers and this kind of things, you know, but you know, I'm focusing on my business, but if there is some kind of possibility to invest less than supposed.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Hi, I'm Jan
Hansen. How many children do you have in your family?
Yes, thank you.
And what do you think? What is the employment situation in your area?
Well, do you think right now? It's really bad because when I look 5 years ago, you see all those trees that were there, they were worked by 10 neighbors, 10 neighbors. And right now it's only me and other people. So they have abandoned the land because it's pretty bad and they are thinking to migrate to the city.
Oh. Have you heard my last question? Have you heard about sustainable agriculture practices? And what do you think about it?
Well, I have heard something. Once those guys from the government, they came and they were distributing some information, and maybe, I remember, they wanted me to change fertilizer. But what I think is that they have no clue. They made those policies, I think, somewhere in the Brussels, somewhere in the net, because the fertilizer they wanted to recommend is just have the opposite effect of what they were saying. But well, I heard a term. And I think it is good as long as I keep my income.
Okay, thank you. How is the chat?
So when I was 11, because my parents didn't want me to continue studying, and my father, he left school when he was 11. My mother, she never went to and my brothers and sisters came to that school early because even we study generally we cannot find employment. Also I wasn't feeling very comfortable when I was
explore the project?
Well, as far as you see, despite this consideration that we were quite a successful country during recent years, and even the crisis hit us quite, sharply, but still we managed it. Still we have problems. The main this is social exclusion and inequity in the country. So the main goal of our project is to address this problem, to address social exclusion and to promote sustainable equity in Finlandia. We believe that this will help us to make the quality of life better for all our citizens and especially for this ethnic minority which suffers most. And for this purpose, we made a project with a time frame of 5 years. During this time, we are going to implement some actions to improve the situation. So, basically, we addressed three main goals. The first one is social exclusion, inclusion through employment. This is what we want to do by increasing general employment in 5 years, especially among people from these vulnerable groups who were hit by the crisis or from minority groups. Because our unemployment reduced in recent years by 8%, and this mostly in agriculture, which is the main our main production, so we still need it. And we suppose that it could decrease also in industries because of the crisis. So we still have this problem to deal with. And as far as we made a survey, we found out that the problem is especially high in western part of our country, where most of our ethnic minority lives. So we suggested actions to improve the situation with this unemployment problem, and we hope they will be successful in 5 years. Our next goal was to was a social inclusion through education. Well, in Finlandia we have a quite high level of human development, which means that the situation that people are full literacy, the enrollment rates are high, and school and education services are available for both boys and girls like equally. But still we have some problems. One of them is that pupils drop out from school at the age of 11, 12 years old during because of various reasons. And this percentage is very high among vulnerable groups, especially this minority group. So what we intended to do is to increase, this dropout from schools, especially focusing on primary stage of schooling. And this is actually what links to the MDG on education, that all the children should finish primary school. But this part of our project also includes additional actions in order to increase social exclusion of minority children into the majority community. As you heard from the interview, they face this problem. And also to make them more competitive on labor markets in long-term perspective, so that they could get a job and build their career and their future. And our third goal, the main goal, was to provide social inclusion in terms of better access and equal access to social services. Because we still have problems, especially in the regions that are least developed, with access to water, electricity, communications, sanitation, and so on. So in this part of our project, we discussed actions about how could we raise this access to make the equity better. And we decided to focus on establishing community projects for people from these areas to make to give them a chance to solve their problems themselves in order to raise empowerment and agency, which also links to human development's main principles. And this action also has another long-term goal, that we would like to focus on sustainable, eco-friendly, or maybe agricultural projects in order to also sustain the environment in this region. So this is like our main goals, and now Anya will present more detailedly our actions and outcomes, what we expect.
But first, I say a few words about the target groups and beneficiaries
We will work mainly with the minority group, because this is our main target group. We want to ease the inclusion to society. However, we know that social and cultural exclusion needs to be done with needs to be provided with the cooperation of the whole community. That's why we have lots of stakeholders and lots of target groups. We will work with managers from the companies that will receive our support. You will see in a moment what kind of support will be that. We will work with teachers, with schools. We want them to show how to include kids from the minorities into the school system and the school lives. We will also work with members of local communities where the people from minority live. Stakeholders are also very various groups, because we want to work with the Ministry of Education, of Labor, and the Ministry of Social Affairs, local municipalities for sure, schools and teachers, and local social workers as well, to show them also some basic ideas how to improve the inclusion. Of course, non-governmental organization, some private sector, and maybe UNESCO as well. The number and the character of this group of stakeholders is that wide, because we believe that the successful social inclusion can be done and achieved and sustained in future only where the three sectors work together, the private, the civic sector and public sector. But in the end, we believe that this is the private sector role to provide employment for people who need that. So you're aware of that. As Rita told you, this is our main goal. This is like the framework of the project, and within we have three objectives in which we design the actions. We want, within 5 years, we want to increase the employment rate, especially in least developed western region of the country. And we have three main activities in this realizing this objective. First, salary subsidies to companies that are willing to employ people from the minority group. Especially, we would like to concentrate and focus on eco-friendly companies and green jobs, because this is like having two goals in one. We want to raise the employment rate and to show the companies that it is worth to invest in the green economy. The second action in this goal is workshop for management. As I told you before, we want to include also management into the project so they can have workshops in crisis solving, problem solving. Multicultural management is the most important here, to understand what are the differences, cultural differences between the workers, and how the people from different cultural backgrounds can better be in a factory or another workplace. Third idea is to provide people with micro grants. These are also for people who are willing to establish their own small business, especially when they have some innovative ideas, especially when they want to work in the local environment, in the local communities, to address the needs of local communities. So these are like micro grants, but also for very small enterprises and for supporting innovative ideas. We want to have at least 100, maybe 150 this kind of micro grants. We believe that this is more or less the amount of the companies that will survive first 2 years, because it's like establishing the company is one thing, but like the point is to make it survive. We of course will provide also the workshops and the training for those people, the basic accounts, accountancy, basic marketing, how to analyze the local market, this kind of training. Of course, it's not only about the money, it's also about the knowledge and about the skills. The second goal is, we, as Rita told you, that we perceive the problem of the rate of kids dropping out from school as very significant. And within 5 years, when the project will be implemented, we want to increase the number of children who complete their basic education. And exactly how Rita said, it is connected to the one of the Millennium Goals. And in this objective, we have training for teachers, of course, also multicultural education, use of creative methods in learning. We want to provide schools with subsidies because we believe that kids drop out from school not only because they don't want to learn or they have to work, but sometimes it's because their parents don't have enough money to provide them with books or any support they need. So we want to do that, to have subsidized for books, for lunches at school, for additional teachers who will sit with the kids in the evening and help them with classes. And third one is studies for classes for those who want to come back to school, also classes for kids who are starting the school to learn them, to learn languages, kind of zero classes before kids start education. And we want to have at least 200 pupils involved in these. And third is increase empowerment among socially excluded citizens. This is easy, this is only one activity, but a big one we want to provide within this goal. We would like to organize at least 100 new local investments, and these will be financed under 50-50 condition. It means that the community gives half of the resources and we provide them with another half. The point is that the minority and majority can work together on this project, can like feel the infrastructural investments in their own project, and they work on it together. So these are the main ideas, but there are of course some additional. I will like briefly say about it. It's of course, like I mentioned, working with NGOs, workshops, and meeting. You want to know because the NGOs are the one who knows the best sometimes what are the needs of the communities. We want to connect the schools with the local business so they can see what kind of labor market needs are, like to see what kind of additional training can be provided for kids. We want to have online database for new entrepreneurs so they can have all data on legal data or data on existing companies to have online and have access to it all the time. Of course, there will be a social campaign on dissemination of results organized. We will cooperate with local media and the website for the project. When we put all good practices, outcomes, individual stories, everything that will be needed. Another kind of information. Good.
Thank you, Anna, for detailed information about the project. And we invite Steen to tell us about the monitoring of our goals.
So just very briefly, what it is we want to achieve by these three objectives is that we want to increase the social inclusion, or want to ensure the social inclusion of the ethnic minorities with all these three objectives. And one thing is that we want to ensure a better self-sufficiency of the ethnic minority by getting into work, having a salary, so that in this way they can avoid the social exclusion. And secondly, we also want that the children, the school children, that they can be better prepared for the first primary years of school, and also to have a higher motivation to complete the studies so that they in fact can see that it will give them a work afterwards or eventually continue with a secondary education. And then finally, we want to empower and increase the agency of the local communities so that they can be part of this, taking more responsibility for their own destiny through infrastructure developments, which they in fact can become entrepreneurs through subsidies and develop these infrastructure themselves. That's all. We'll now go to the issue of monitoring, because we find this to be a very essential part of our project, because what you haven't seen specifically here, but we have quantified our So basically all our goals, we have put them into quantifiable data so that it will be quite easy, if we can collect the data, to assess how well are we performing in terms of achieving the goals that we have set, like clear goals. And we'll do it on in different levels. First of all, we want to do like biannual reports and surveys. That means in 2014, the mid-term, and then in the final implementation year in 2016. And that will cover all the data and all the quantifiable data we want to verify. In addition to that, we also want to collect annual data on the disaggregated data regarding the social minority. It's especially related to school attendance, is related to employment and to salaries. So these are like more easily data that are ready to collect. And the point of this is also not only to assess what have we achieved the overall goals, but during the project, by having annual collection of data, we can also adjust the implementation of the project. Let's see if we find some weak spots, some shortcomings, or some issues that are lagging behind. We can, by having data each year, we can adjust the implementation. And on an overall level, we also want to assess all the different like working groups that Anya was talking about. What's the effect of those? Does it lead to less social exclusion? Do the companies, do the schools, do the teachers, do they benefit from these workshops that we will have? We will make a complete report on the methodology and also on the survey questions and everything like this. It will be like a separate annex to this project, so that this will be clear from the beginning. And finally, before we start all this, we'll do some desk research to basically to specify what kind of legislation do we have in place, and also to collect those essential data that we'll monitor through the projects. We know what is the starting point before we continue on this. And we'll talk a little bit about the budget, but not in detail, but we find it very important that there will be allocated enough both personnel but also financial resources in order to ensure the proper monitoring. And now, Asoud will continue with some of the policy recommendations.
Well, before I start, I would like to thank to the project team, because actually I have the concrete outcome of the project. I was a small minority, and it just right now I'm giving policy recommendations. Things happen in Finlandia. Well, we have a few recommendations for some ministries. Well, first of all, it's the Ministry for Social Affairs. I'm not going to explain all of them in paper, we explain, but we just put bullet points in here. Like, one of them is expansion of social security for vulnerable groups, because they have difficulty to access to health system, also education system, so maybe the expansion of social security can be helpful for them to access these services. Monitoring legislative frameworks in implementation is another thing, because we recommend government to prepare a social inclusion program. So, but the preparation of the program is not enough, also implementation should be monitored. Improve living conditions of social minorities, because they have few access to sanitation, also water and electricity, so infrastructure should be improved. And could you pass to education? And it's for Ministry of Education. I will pass the first four of them, because we already mentioned during the project part. But one of them is important, raise awareness of the importance of education, because some of the case is not only because they don't have enough financial resources or they don't have access to schools, but sometimes they are thinking that education is not important. So maybe some raise awareness activities for the importance of education, like regular meetings or trainings for families, can be beneficial. Also implement a vocational training for young populations who are dropped out from school when they were young. It could be also useful at the end, they can also access to the labor market. These are the recommendations for Ministry of Agriculture: provision of microcredits to support sustainable agriculture projects among minorities, promote trainings regarding sustainable agriculture practices among farmers, and promotion of small scale farming or urban farming, especially for minorities again in a small land. Maybe this can be also another solution to solve their problem to food access. And for Ministry of Finances in the project, we recommend to provide subsidies to business that embrace sustainable practices and tax privileges to business that adopt sustainable practices. Also for environment, especially for the textile and car industry, implement measures in order to reduce energy consumption and also natural resources consumption, and implement reduction of raw materials. And at the end, for the corruption, we first recommend to create an external institution which will monitor, probably which will include all the stakeholders and monitor the corruption process, and promote transparency of all governmental processes, maybe with e-government system, and improve the cooperation among the different ministries in order to increase the efficiency and accountability of policies.
Our final part of our presentation. Let's welcome our project team and show the pictures of our